It's the 12th of July, 1975. The venue, Gothenburg, Sweden.
I'd gone over and over in my mind so many times how many times I was going to run that race. I mean, all I didn't think about winning, I thought about breaking the world record. I had 10 hours just sitting in a bedroom, getting up, sleeping, watching the wind, watching the flags. I mean, this was all a part of the race. I imagined myself in my mind coming down the last 120 meters all the time. And this was my final victory. I mean, this was my day.
John Walken, look at him.
I mean, I was absolutely ecstatic because I knew as soon as I crossed the line, the reaction from the crowd, the reaction from the press, that I had broken the world record. I didn't know I'd run under 350, and it was only, I was travelling with a journalist by the name of Ivan Agnew, who was also writing a book called Kiwis Can Fly at the time, and it was only when he sort of thrust a watch under my face and said, you've broken 350, I had no idea what the time was.
And remember the time, 349.6.
It wasn't until I got back to the hotel room, I mean, all the adulation had died down, the three victory laps, the flowers, the kisses, I mean, the waving to the crowd, I mean, all that had gone. And it wasn't until I got back to the hotel room and settled down with a couple of beers that the phone started ringing from all over the world. Then I realised what I'd done.
One year after becoming the first man on Earth to run a mile in under 3 minutes 50 seconds, John Walker confirmed his place in history as one of the all-time great middle-distance runners. It's Montreal, 1976, the last lap of the Olympic Games 1500-meter final. Walker puts on a display of majestic power running and takes the gold medal.
Cares about second or third. If you can take the silver medal and or the bronze medal and look again, no one really cares. I mean, the gold medal is the pinnacle. I mean, it's the answer. No one really writes about second or third. It's the champion is the person who wins, and the person that can stave off and beat the best in the world. Winning is everything. If you don't win, I mean, you're nothing. And the adulation and the publicity that came from breaking 350 was probably four times more than ever winning the Olympic gold. I wasn't expected to run under 350 for the mile. I was expected to win the Olympic gold medal. But I think winning the gold medal really captured and captivated the whole career. I mean, 1976, my career basically finished, although